Rejoice Ministries.
Greetings in the most precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Today we are going to see Nehemiah chapter 13 part 2 that starts from verse 10 onwards. I also found that the portions of the Levites had not been given to them, so that the Levites and the singers who did the work had fled each to his field. So I confronted the officials and said, "Why is the house of God forsaken?" And I gathered them together and set them in their stations. So here we see the two or three verses which says as how the next issue came up for Nehemiah to plan out how to manage the situation was the Levites and the singers who were there in the courts of the temple were driven out, and so they ran away. You can just imagine what Tobiah and his people, and also this Eliashib, the high priest, and his people would have done to these Levites and singers. They would have chased them out, maybe by force. And so the Levites and the singers, they couldn't stand the torment and the torture of these people, that they had run away to their own fields. And then we should also understand that when these people are not there in the premises, the other people, that is the believers and whoever was to the Israelites who came to the temple of God for worship, they stopped coming. Because of these two men having more power over everybody else, when the Levites and the singers had also run away from their sight, the other people also never came. Therefore, they could not arrange to have any worship inside the temple. And also we see that these people had started to work even on the day of Sabbath. The day of Sabbath is a day when they have everything away, and so that they would, with their whole heart and mind, they would worship only God. That is how God wanted them to conduct Sabbath. But because these men had run away, Sabbath wasn't taken care of in the right way, because the Levites were not there and also the singers were not there. So what does God say about these Levites? He says in Psalm 105 in the verse 15, he says, "Touch not my anointed ones, do my prophets no harm." So we should not talk a word about the anointed pastors and priests and evangelists and apostles, also prophets. We should not do any harm to them. We should not touch God's anointed ones, and we should not do any harm to prophets. That's what God says. Even in 1 Chronicles chapter 16 verse 22, he says the same thing about his own people. He says, "Touch not my anointed ones, do my prophets no harm." You find that during Nehemiah's time, this high priest called Eliashib has done great damage, touched them. He has done harm to the Levites and his anointed people. So we would see, like, what would be the punishment, great punishment, the curse that falls on this Eliashib for having done all these wrong things, sins against God himself. We find that Levites were God's children, and so they did not retaliate. They did not fight back. They were innocent people, and so they ran away from the whole place. Now, when situations come like this, when people who have more power try to overpower us, what do? We do not stand against them. We just flee. But Nehemiah finds a time to bring them back and put them in their place. That is a good thing that Nehemiah is doing. We will see here, we will continue to see Nehemiah chapter 13 from verse 12 onwards. I will read. "Then all Judah brought the tithe of the grain, wine and oil into the storehouses, and they appointed as treasurers over the storehouses Shelemiah the priest, Zadok the scribe, Pedaiah of the Levites, and their assistant Hanan the son of Zachar, son of Mattaniah, for they were considered reliable and their duty was to distribute to their brothers. Remember me, O my God, concerning this, and do not wipe out my good deeds that I have done for the house of my God and for his service. So with this we end the second part of Nehemiah chapter 13, and it is about how Nehemiah had brought back all the Levites and all those ministers of God who were doing a good job, and he is also listing a few ministers, their names, and they found them all reliable to do the right thing for God. So here we see that anything goes wrong, we are put in position as ministers, as doctors, as advocates, as teachers, in any position we are, we have to see whether the right is done. This is one thing that God is expecting us, as Nehemiah did it. We are expected to do the right thing. When something wrong goes, we just cannot move away as we never know it. We should do something really the right way as it pleases God. We cannot shirk our responsibilities and say it is not my work, it is not my duty. Actually, Nehemiah was a governor and he has nothing to do with the temple. But when he saw that things went wrong in the temple, he took challenge and he took the leadership to put everything in the right way which would please God. And so all the Levites and all the singers came again, and all the people who ran away, they brought their tithe and the offerings, and the worship that was to be done every Sabbath, it started to happen. So all glory to God. We should look for people like Nehemiah, and we should say to God, God, make me like Nehemiah, give me the boldness and courage to stand against wrong things that are happening in the world. In whichever department we are put in, we have to stand for God. Amen. We will pray. Heavenly Father, we look up to you for your grace, mercy and compassion. Even as we pray now, Lord, we know that there are a lot of bad things and wrong things which are happening in the world, and we are kept alive and we are given wisdom and knowledge and courage and boldness to stand up, to rise up to the occasion like Nehemiah did and set right everything good, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Be with us, and like you were with Nehemiah, be with us and help us to do the right things in our world. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
மேலும் எங்களை தொடர்பு கொள்ள ரிஜாய்ஸ் மினிஸ்ட்ரீஸ் இவாஞ்சலிஸ்ட் டாக்டர் டாப்னி ஜோசப், செல் 9171100011. கர்த்தர்தாமே உங்கள் ஒவ்வொருவரையும் ஆசீர்வைத்து காப்பாராக. ஆமென்.
Joy Creative Production.
For video coverage and editing, audio recording and editing, promo for advertisement, graphic design.
Contact 9042494996.